Shalom. This week's Haftarah is from Parashat Emor. The connection to the Parsha is that both the Haftarah and the Parsha discuss about the Kohanim, the priests, and their work they need to do. In the Torah reading, it talks about what they need to do in the Mishkan, in the tabernacle, the temporary and traveling sanctuary for the Jewish people. And here, the Haftarah from the book of Yechezkel talks about in the time of the Messiah, in the third and final Beit HaMikdash, how things are going to go for the Kohanim at that time. Remember, Yechezkel, Chazak El, God will strengthen me, lived in the time about 2,500 years ago when he saw the destruction of the Holy Temple, as well as he was part of the exiles, and then he was this prophet that saw the future and spoke to Israel about their returning to the land of Israel, and that a day will come when they will rebuild the Beit HaMikdash. Now, we talk about the third and final Beit HaMikdash. And the Haftarah starts with V'ha-Kohanim V'ha-Leviyim B'nei Tzadok. There were many families of Kohanim, and one of them was the Tzadok family. Now, why did Hashem pick that family? Well, back in the time of Shlomo HaMelech, you had the Tzadok family, and this was the one group of Kohanim that actually stuck to the rules that God asked them to do. So now God is saying, in the time of the Mashiach, the descendants of the Tzadok family are going to be the ones that are doing the Avodah, the work that is going to be done in the Beit HaMikdash. And now the Haftarah goes on to describe the clothing that the Kohen will wear. And that it mentions about how they used to have haircuts every day, the Kohanim, that every single hair in their head was precisely the same length. And they wore these beautiful clothing, and it describes the hat the Kohen would wear and the robes that the Kohen would wear. That the Haftarah now talks about the halachot that pertains to the Kohanim. Now, when they were making the Tanakh, they were codifying the books of the prophets. There's some conflict in the book of Ezekiel, that information that conflicts with the Torah. And it is said that there was this great rabbi who reconciled all the differences, and then they permitted the book of Ezekiel to go into the Tanakh, into the books of the prophets. So it's explaining about what the Kohanim could do, as far as their haircuts go, as far as whether they're or not they're allowed to drink wine or not, which they're not allowed to, as far as doing the service in the temple, as well as that who they can marry, that they cannot marry a widow or a divorcee. So these are some of the things that the Haftarah talks about. Also, they talk about the gifts that were given to the Kohanim and whether they were allowed to keep them. And then finally, the Haftarah ends with the halacha that they are not allowed to eat anything tarefa unevela. That the obvious, but nevertheless it is mentioned. So here we have this wonderful Haftarah that Ezekiel is talking about the future, and he is explaining to us what the Beit HaMikdash is going to be like on a day and the work that the Kohanim will do in it. So what do we learn from this? Is that God has given us a carrot stick for the future. He's given us a roadmap. He's going to tell us what's going to happen through the Nevi'im we hear. And that therefore, once we have a target, it's much easier to work towards that goal. It's called beginning with the end in mind. And that's what we're doing here. We are beginning with the Mashiach and the third Beit HaMikdash in mind, and then every day we live our life trying to be consistent. We're coming closer and closer to Hashem. Enjoy the Haftarah. Shabbat Shalom.